Hello, this is Andrew Kruger, Product Manager for Qlik in Printing. This video is going to discuss the exercise of promoting a Qlik Sense on-demand object between environments. So we've often got the question of how do I change this Qlik Sense on-demand and printing server URLs as I promote through my environments? So the assumption that we have for this video is that you have a Qlik Sense app that has been deployed and configured with an in-printing connection in your target environments. So that could be that you have a dev and a prod environment. So the strategy we're going to use is as follows. Within the Qlik Sense app, we're going to use the container object to hold conditional on-demand objects. We're going to have an on-demand object for each target environment. So if you have a dev and a prod, you'll have one for each. Within each of those on-demand objects, you're going to set the on-demand app connection filter toggle to the off position. This ensures that the on-demand object can connect to the Qlik in Printing servers without constraint and without throwing errors within your Qlik Sense app. It's important to note that you will need to have permissions when configuring the on-demand objects to access the target in printing environments. Once we have the container object that contains the on-demand objects for each environment, we're going to use a local variable in the Sense document. For the purpose of this example, I've set that variable to equal the computer name. You can use your own strategy. We're then going to use that variable in the show hide conditions on each of the objects within the container. Little note here that once you set the show condition for the object that you're not of the environment that you're not working in, you won't be able to continue to configure that object. Once you've completed your configuration of the container and the objects, you will export your Sense app or your dashboard from your dev environment and promote it into your production environment. And a key caveat is to make sure when it gets to the production environment or any other environment you're promoting it to, that you refresh your in-printing connection. So let's take a look. So for the purpose of this demo, I have two environments, a development environment and a production environment. Both have been configured as per setup guidelines. They're on the same domain. And the dashboard has been previously published and connected within both environments. So to get started, we're going to edit our dashboard in our development environment. We're going to introduce the container object to the sheet. We're going to add our on-demand components. The first component that I'm adding will be the development component. And the second component that I'm going to add is for the production instance. So again, both of these components will have a show hide condition on them that we'll configure later on that will make them visible in the appropriate environment. Now we'll go and we'll configure the development component. We'll grab our in-printing URL. We'll select the app connection. And we'll set this toggle, the app connection filter, to off. This will ensure that this component does not throw errors when it's in the production environment. So now that we've configured the development component, we can verify that it's actually functioning. So I have two reports in my in-printing instance that are set up for on-demand, and I can test those reports. So now that we've confirmed that, we might do a little bit of cleanup here. We'll add the appropriate label to the button.
Here we can see I've got two buttons. They're visible. I haven't put the show hide condition on it yet. Now I'm going to set my local variable to support the show hide condition. So in this case, I've got my own variable naming convention. You have yours. And again, I'm going to use the reference to the computer name. This is quite easy for me in this development environment. If you have alternate strategies for this, you're welcome to use them. Now I'm going to set my show hide condition. So very simple condition. I'm saying if the variable equals the environment, then true. If false, don't show. So now I can go and configure my production environment. Again, I'm going to want this toggle set to off. You can see here that I had two apps in the production environment set up, and I've got one connection to the sales demo. The app connection filter is off. So right now I'm in a development environment, and I have configured that on-demand component to point to the production environment. So once I set this condition on the production component, I won't be able to open the edit properties because I'm currently in the development environment. Final maintenance step here, I'm going to remove some of the text around the container object to make it a little bit more readable. So now that I'm happy with my app, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to export the app. And of course, I'm going to go to my production environment, the QMC here. I'm going to import that same application. So of course, the expectation here is that this app already has the imprinting connections. We're not going to show you that exercise. So now that we're in the production environment, we'll see that the conditional show hide on demand button is displayed for production. Before using it, we're going to go and refresh the cache for the connection in the production environment. And now we can run our on-demand report from our Sense app that's in the production environment without having edited the Sense app in the production environment. So let's recap. We'll see here that we've got the container object, we've used a local variable, and we have two on-demand components that conditionally show within the container. Each on-demand component has the app connection filter toggled to the off position so that in the alternate environment, it's not throwing any errors. Thank you for watching this video on how to configure the Sense on-demand objects between different environments. Hope you found this helpful.